Hello viewers, welcome to my channel. I'm Hashim Ali Khan. Now I'm going to continue the problems on techniques of financial statement analysis. Already four main problems and six short problems I have completed on this topic of techniques of analysis of financial statements. Before the two videos I have uploaded on the theory regarding what are the different techniques. Comparative statement, common size statement, and trend analysis. All these things I have already uploaded. If you have not watched those videos, I suggest you to go to the playlist of my channel. Select the subject cost control and management accounting. Select the video of techniques of financial statement analysis. Watch the first two videos. Be acquainted. Be clear about the meaning, concept, and procedure of these three techniques: comparative, common size, and trend analysis. Now, before starting the fifth problem, I expect my viewers to have a printout of the problems which are given in the link under my description. Always keep it ready. Take the screenshot of the solution of this fifth problem, then I'll explain it. Now, see the fifth problem. The following is the statement of profit and loss of Tanushree Limited for the year 2015 and its previous year. That means 2014-2015. 2 years data is given. And the particulars, revenue from operations. That means we have to make comparative income statement. So, revenue from operations, return of revenue from operations. One point you remember, revenue from operations are sales. And return of revenue from operations, these are sales return. So normally what we'll do, from sales we deduct sales return. So here from revenue from operations, we subtract return from revenue from operation. Then cost of revenue from operations, these are the cost of sales. From sales, if we deduct cost of sales, we'll get the gross profit. Same procedure we'll do. And then we have administration expenses, then selling expenses, interest paid, interest and dividend, loss on sale of plant, profit on sale of plant, purchase discount, income tax, net profit. Present the above data in suitable comparative form. So it is asking you to present this data in a comparative income statement form. So we have to make comparative only 2 years, last year 2014, current year 2015. It is not asking you to give the interpretation. So simply we are making the comparative income statement as usual. So comparative income statement for the year 2014-2015. Absolute change, percentage change. Already 2-3 problems I have explained in detail. Now, incomes. Incomes are revenue from operations given in the problem. First of all, we fill up the first two columns. Don't write anything in absolute change, percentage change. Afterwards I'll explain. First of all, whatever values are given, figures are given for 2014 and 2015, we will write it down as it is. So revenue from operations 14-15, then return of revenue from operation deducted. So revenue minus return for return of revenue from operations, net revenue, net sales, we got it. Other incomes are purchase discount, then cost, the total income is A. Cost of revenue from operations, this is B. So A minus B is the gross profit. Gross profit is A minus B, income minus cost of sales, gross profit. From gross profit we subtract operating expenses. Now here in this problem only two operating expenses are given, that is administration and selling expenses. These two total got it as D. So here C is the gross profit and D is the operating expense. C minus D is the operating profit. C is here and D is here. So 2,50,868 minus 1,38,354. You'll get 1,12,514. This is the operating profit, right? Now to this we add a non-operating income. The non-operating incomes are interest and dividend, then profit on sale of land. So these two incomes are called non-operating incomes. So non-operating incomes, F. Then non-operating expenses are interest paid and loss on sale of plant. These two are non-operating expenses. This is denoted as G. So now carefully you see, operating profit is E, non-operating income is F, non-operating expenses is G. Now profit before tax is E plus F minus G, because non-operating income should be added and non-operating expenses should be deducted. So E plus F minus G is equal to profit before tax. So 1 lakh here, 1,12,514 plus 6,795 minus 5,529, you will get 1,13,780. Same procedure for 2015 also. So this is the profit before tax. From this we deduct income tax that is given in the problem. 43,038 and 8,390. These are the income tax given. Subtract, we'll get net profit 70,742 and 88,851. That is given in the problem. So first two columns I have taken. Only the thing is we have taken in a format. How to compute, how to make the income statement. Right? Now, as usual, we have to find out absolute change and percentage change. Absolute change, I already told you, current year value minus last year value. Current year is 2015. Last year is 2014. So take the value 834,250 minus 721,456. What you'll get? 1,12,794. This is the absolute change. Now, percentage change, absolute change divided by last year figure into 100. What is the absolute change? 1,12,794 divided by 721,456 into 100. You will get 15.63%. This is the percentage change. Same is the case here. 13,903 minus 11,588. You will get 2,315. Now 2,315 divided by 11,588 into 100, you will get 19.98. So very easy, absolute change is equal to current year value minus last year value. And percentage change is absolute change divided by last year value into 100. Like this, you have to calculate, make the calculations for all the values. So this is the complete presentation of comparative income statement. This is the end of problem number 5. Come on, now we'll start the next problem. Problem number 6. See carefully. From the following data pertaining to Mamta Limited, prepare comparative statement of profit and loss. That means we have to prepare comparative income statement. The data is given for 2016 and 2017. Sales, gross profit ratio, percentage 30%, 40%. And administrative expenses 40,000, 1 lakh. And income tax percentage 50%. It's a very small problem. See carefully. Mamta Limited comparative income statement for 2016-17. So one column 16-17. Afterwards, you calculate absolute change and percentage change. First of all, sales are given last year 6 lakh, current year 8 lakh. So 6 lakh, 8 lakh. From sales, we have to subtract cost of goods sold. Then we will get the gross profit. In our problem, cost of goods sold is not given. But gross profit ratio is given. Gross profit ratio is 30%. So this 30% of sales. GP ratio always will be calculated on sales. So this 30% is given and sales are 6 lakh. So calculate 30% of 6 lakh. 30% of 6 lakh, you will get 1,80,000. So gross profit we got 1,80,000. Similarly, for next year 2017, the sales are 8 lakh and gross profit percentage is 40%. So 40% of 8 lakhs, you will get 3,20,000. So instead of percentage, we want the gross profit. So 30% of sales and 40% of sales. 30% of 6 lakh comes to 1,80,000. 40% of 8 lakh comes to 3,20,000. Now see here. 6 lakh rupees sales and 1,80,000 is the gross profit after deducting cost of goods sold. So what, how to find out cost of goods sold? 6 lakh minus 1,80,000. 6 lakh minus 1,80,000, you will get 4,20,000. This 4,20,000 is the cost of goods sold. It is not given in the problem. We have calculated. Because we are having sales and we are having gross profit. So sales minus gross profit, you will get cost of goods sold. Write it. In a notebook, you write on. Sales minus gross profit is equal to cost of goods sold. So 6 lakh minus 1,80,000, 4,20,000. 8 lakh minus 3,20,000, you get 4,80,000. That's it. After getting gross profit, deduct administrative expenses. It is given in the problem. 40,000, 1 lakh. 40,000, 1 lakh. Deduct 180 minus 40. 140 is the profit before tax. Similarly, 320 minus 1 lakh. 2,20,000 is the profit before tax. From profit before tax, subtract income tax. Here it is given income tax percentage 50% for both the years. So 50% on PBT. 50% on PBT, profit before tax. So 50% of 1,40,000, you'll get 70,000. 50% of 2,20,000, you'll get 1,10,000. We got income tax. Subtract income tax, we'll get profit after tax. So 140 minus 70, 70,000. 220 minus 110, 1,10,000. This is the profit after tax. That's all. Now easily we can find out absolute change and percentage change. Current year value minus last year value. 8 lakh minus 6 lakh. 2 lakh. This is the absolute change. Now percentage change. 2 lakh divided by last year's figure. Last year figure is 6 lakh. So 2 lakh divided by 6 lakh into 100. You'll get 33.33. Similarly, 4,80,000 minus 4,20,000 is 60,000. 60,000 divided by 4,20,000 into 100, you'll get 14.2. Like this, as usual, we have calculated the absolute change and percentage change. That's it. So this is the end of sixth problem, income statement. Now, seventh problem, it is asking you to make the comparative balance sheet. So far, we have done the problems only on comparative income statement. This is the first problem where we are finding out comparative balance sheet. Seventh problem. From the following balance sheet of Jishnu Deep Limited as at 31st March 2017 and 2016. So last year 2016 and current year 2017. Prepare comparative balance sheet. So first of all, you copy down the format of the balance sheet. Here you can see balance sheet as at 31st March 2016-2017. So whatever format is given, the same format, the same particulars I have copied. No change at all. Same format. Equity and liability, shareholders fund, share capital, equity share capital, preference share capital, reserves and surplus, non-current liability, 9% debentures, loan from bank, then current liability, trade payable, short-term provisions. The total of the liability, 11,50,000 last year. Current year 15,50,000. In the problem, first column is 2017, second column is 2016, but we need first column 16 and second column 2017. So carefully you see, equity share capital last year 3 lakh, current year 4,50,000. So last year 3 lakh, current year 4,50,000. Like this, you copy down all the values which are given in the problem for 2016 and 2017, whatever is given in the problem. That's it. Once, if you have copied down this one from the problem, now easily we can calculate absolute change and percentage change as usual. What we have done in the previous problems in income statement. Now absolute change. Current year value minus last year value into 100. Oh, sorry. Current year value minus last year value. So 4,50,000 minus 3 lakh. 1,50,000. Absolute change. 1,50,000. So percentage change. Absolute change divided by last year figure into 100. So absolute change 1,50,000. 1,50,000 divided by 3 lakh into 100. 50%. Similarly, 3 lakh minus 1,50,000 is 1,50,000. 1,50,000 divided by 1,50,000 into 100. 100%. Here 150, 150, no change. Put a dash in absolute change and percentage change. Same procedure for here. all these values as usual, you have to calculate absolute change and percentage change. So this is the end of problem number 7.